Well, here's a provocative study to tell you about. There's a new study out of UCLA that says that legalizing undocumented or illegal immigrants would boost our economy, even in this recession. So should we start granting citizenship to illegals, or is this study off base? To debate the issue this morning, we're joined by Ben Johnson, Executive Director of American Immigration Council, and Bob Dane with the Federation for Immigration Reform. Welcome, gentlemen, to both of you.
Good morning.
All right, so Bob, let me start with you. The UCLA study says that history shows that when you legalize undocumented or illegal workers, the economy improves because their wages go up, they pay taxes and insurance, they buy houses and merchandise. All of this boosts the economy. Bob, why don't you agree with that?
Mathematical fantasy. That's what the study is. This is a last-ditch pitch by a very desperate far left who have been trying to peddle amnesty to the American public, and they're simply not buying it. They're using this ludicrous study to have us believe that amnesty is somehow the new economic stimulus bill. It isn't. It is yet another massive bailout to taxpayers for the benefit of 13 million illegal aliens, and a wholesale sellout to American workers. Look, just because you administratively convert 13 million illegal aliens from illegal status to legal status does not change the fact that they're overwhelmingly poorly skilled, poorly educated, inadequately able to contribute and to compete in today's society. And most importantly, it does not change the fact that they're heavily government dependent,
okay,
to the tune of $700 billion a year if we were to make them legal, because
okay,
they'd be eligible for additional local, state, and federal government benefits.
Okay, Ben, you believe in the study's findings. Tell us why.
Well, this study says two things. It says, first of all, the goal of any immigration reform effort needs to be what's good for the American economy, what's good for the American workers, right? This is about creating an American immigration system. And then what the study finds is that if you do that right, if you reform the system from top to bottom, including getting smarter and more efficient about enforcement, right? Let's focus on the right priorities, and including a program for those folks that are here already in our economy, who violated the law, if you require them to get a legal status, ask them to and expect them to speak English and participate in the economy in more effective ways, it helps the economy to the tune of about $1.5 trillion over 10 years at a time when we need that kind of participation and legal participation in our economy.
You know, the study was based on what happened, they say, in 1986 during a similar economic downturn under President Reagan, when 3 million illegal immigrants became legal. They say that they got better paying jobs, they became better educated, to your point, resulting in more spending and more tax revenue. How can you dispute history?
Well, what happened after the 1986 amnesty is we had another round of illegal aliens coming in, 13 million illegal aliens. Look, this ought to be an affront to every American that this administration is even entertaining the concept of amnesty in today's economy. And frankly, a word to the wise to politicians, if you put your ink on an amnesty bill in today's economy, the American worker and the American voter will show you to the door on Election Day.
Okay, Ben, we'll give you the last word, your response.
Listen, everybody recognizes that the system is broken. We can't continue to do nothing about this particular problem. So hopefully members of Congress have the courage to do this in a way that's beneficial to the American workers. And everybody knows that if it's harder for employers to exploit workers, it helps all the workers in that job market.
Ben Johnson, Bob Dane, we have to leave it there. Thanks for coming in to debate this provocative new study. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's go over to Clayton for what's coming up.